students, welcome to my today's video lecture on chemical kinetics. Today we will study about the numericals based on first order reaction. So first of all, let us see few important formulas. First formula is integrated first order reaction. K is equal to 2.303 upon T log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of AT. Next is half-life period T half is equal to 0.693 upon rate constant K. And the third one is integrated rate law for gas phase reaction, which is K is equal to 2.303 upon T log to the base of 10 of P1 upon 2 times P1 minus P. So let us begin with the first problem. In a first order reaction, the concentration of the reactant decreases from 20 m mole dm raised to minus 3 to 8 m mole dm raised to minus 3 in 38 minutes. What is the half-life of a reaction? So let us write what is given. Concentration of A0 has been given to us as 20 m mole dm raised to minus 3. Then concentration of AT has been given to us as 8 m mole dm raised to minus 3. Then T has been given, that is 38 minutes. And we have to calculate half-life, that is T half. We have to calculate T half. So what should be the formula? T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. But we do not have rate constant K. So for that we need to determine K. So the next formula we should take is K is equal to 2.303 upon T log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of AT, which is integrated rate law for first order reaction. Therefore K will be equal to 2.303 upon, what is T? It is 38 minutes log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0. Now concentration of A0 is 20 upon concentration of AT. It is 8. So 20 by 8, that will give you 2.303 upon 38 log to the base of 10 of. What does 20 by 8 give us? It gives us 2.5. And again we have to find log of 2.5. Therefore K is equal to 2.303 multiplied by log to the base of 2.5. That is 0.3979 upon 38. Now you can take the log of numerator, log of 2.303 plus log of 0.3979 and carry out the addition of that and then subtract the log of 38 out of it. So I will show the log calculations over here. Log of 2.303 plus log of 0.3979. So what is the log of 2.303? It is 0.3623. And the log of 0.3979, you can refer your log books, it is bar 1.5998. Then add the two, you get 12.9621. And then subtract the log of 38 from it. So minus the log of 38. So what is the log of 38? 38 in 0, it will give you 1.5798. And then subtract the 2, you get 2.3823. Then find the anti-log. Find the anti-log. Anti-log of 0.3823 into 10 raised to minus 2. Bar 2 I have taken as 10 raised to minus 2. Now take the anti-log of 0.38 into and add the difference of 3 to it. You will get the answer as 2.412. And this 10 raised to minus 2 as it is. So final answer for K gives you K is equal to 2.412 into 10 raised to minus 2. Or you can also write this as 0.02412. It is a rate constant and time has been given to you in minutes. So you have to write this rate constant as per minute. K is equal to 0.02412 per minute. So we have found out K. Now we can put this, the value of K in T-half formula. You will get your T-half. So what is T-half now? Therefore, T-half is equal to 0.693 upon K. And your K is 0.02412. Again, we need to calculate the log of 0.693 and then subtract the log of 0.02412 from it. Find the anti-log of the obtained factor. You will get the final answer as T half. So what is the log of 0.693? I will do the calculation here. Log of 0.693 plus 0.693 minus log of 0.02412. So 69 in 3. What is the log? Bar 1.8407. Subtract the log of 0.02412 from it. Bar 2.3824. Subtract the 2, you get 1.4583. And then find antilog of this. Antilog will be, you have to find the antilog of 0.45 in 8 and take the difference of 3. So the antilog will be, I'm writing here, antilog of 0.4583. And this characteristic 1, I'm taking it as 10 raised to 1 over here. So 0.45 in 8, you have to take the antilog of it and add the difference of 3 to it. What answer you get? You get that answer as 2.873 into 10 raised to 1. That means it becomes 28.73. So your T half will be equal to 28.73. The answer will be in minute again. So the half life period, that is T half, is 28.73 minutes. I'll explain again. In the first order reaction, concentration of reactant, initial reactant A0 has been given as 20m mol dm raised to minus 3. And concentration of At is given to you. That is, at time t, the concentration of the same reactant has been given as 8m mol dm raised to minus 3. Then the time has been given as 38 minutes. And you have to find out t half, that is half life period. Then t half, on the basis of first order reaction, t half is 0.693 upon k. But we don't have the value of k. So we have to take k from integrated rate law first order reaction. That is, k is equal to 2.303 upon t log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of At. Then k is equal to, I am substituting the values of A0 and At, I get k is equal to 2.303 upon 38 log to the base of 10 of concentration of 20 upon concentration of 8. Simplify this 20 by 8, you get the value as 2.5. Again find the log of 2.5, you get that as 0.3979. Then take the product of 2.303 and 0.397. Find the log of both the terms, that is 2.303 and 0.3979 in the numerator. Add their logs and then subtract the log of 38 out of 8. So the log of 2.303, I have written 0.3623, and the log of 0.3979, that is bar 1.5998. Adding the two, I get bar 1.9621, and then subtracting the log of 38 from it, that is minus 1.5798, I get bar 2.3823. Then I take the anti-log of 0.38 in 2 and add the difference of 3. And this bar 2 I have taken as 10 raised to minus 2. What is the anti-log of this term 0.3823? I get it as 2.412 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay, so what is the value of k? That is either 2.412 into 10 raised to minus 2, or it is equal to 0.02412 minute raised to minus 1. Then t half is equal to 0.693 upon k. So the value of k you have found out. Substitute it over here. Half life period after the calculation of these two terms. That is log of 0.693 minus the log of 0.02412. The logs have been written over here. We get 1.4583. Take the anti-log of 0.45 in 8 and add the difference of 3 to it. What you get? You get 2.873 as the anti-log. And this 1 point I have taken as into 10 raised to 1. That means your answer is 28.73. The decimal point will be shifted ahead. So final answer of half-life period is equal to 28.73 minutes. So this is your first sum. So the next problem is, a first order reaction takes 40 minutes for 30% decomposition. Calculate its half life. Concentration of A0, if assumed to be 100%, then concentration of At will be equal to, 30% has been decomposed, so it will be 100 minus 30, that is equal to 70. And T has been given to you, time has been given to you, that is 40 minutes. And you have to find out T half. So according to the first order reaction, T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. But we don't have k here. Again we have to find k is equal to, we can find k by taking integrated rate law for first order reaction. That is, k is equal to 2.303 upon t log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of At. Substitute the values. K is equal to 2.303 upon 40 log to the base of 10 of A0 is 100 upon concentration of 80, that is 70. That is 70. So 100 upon 7. You can simplify 10 upon 7, you get it as 1.429. So 2.303 upon 40 into log to the base of 10 of 10 by 7, that is 1.429. And again you have to find the log of 1.429. 2.303, find the log of 1.429, that is 14 into and the difference of 9. You will get the answer as 0.1550 upon this 40. Then take the log of 2.303 plus the log of 0.1550. which is equal to 0.3623. Log of 2.303 is 0.3623 and the log of 0.1550, that is 15 in 5 and difference is nothing, that is 0. So 15 in 5, that will give you bar 1.1903. Add the two, you get it as bar 1.5526 and then subtract the log of 40 from it. So the log of 40 will give you 1.6021. Calculate this, you get it as 3 bar 0.9505. 6 minus 1 5, 2 minus 2 0, 5, carry your 15 minus 6, that will give you 9. So here you will get bar 2 minus 2 minus 1, that will give you 3 bar, and then find the anti log of it. So anti log of 0.9505 into bar 3, that is 10 raised to minus 3. So antilog of 95 and 0 and the difference of 5 should be taken and the value will be 8.923 into 10 raised to minus 3. So that is your K. K is equal to 8.923 into 10 raised to minus 3. Again, it will be in minute raised to minus 1. And then find T half. T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. So 0.693 upon 8.923 into 10 raised to minus 3. In same way, take the log of numerator, that is 0.693, and subtract the log of 8.923 out of it. Take the antilog of the term obtained and you will get your final answer, that is 77.67. You get it as 77.67 minutes. That is your T half. Now we come to the next problem, that is the half life of first order reaction is 990 seconds. If the initial concentration of reactant is 0.08 mole dm raised to minus 3, what concentration would remain after 35 minutes? So what has been given to you? T half has been given to you. T half is given as 990 second. And initial concentration, that is A0, has been given to us as 0.08 mole dm raised to minus 3. What concentration would remain? That means concentration of 80 has been asked. after 35 minutes. That means T has been given to you. That is 35 minutes. Now, as the half-life is given in second, we have to convert this T also in second. So, 35 into 60. 1 minute corresponds to 1 minute corresponds to 60 seconds. Therefore, 35 minutes will correspond to 35 multiplied by 60, that is equal to 2100 seconds. So, T has been written here. So, concentration of AT has to be found out. So, what is our formula? Problem is based on first order reaction. So, integrated rate law for first order reaction should be written as K is equal to 2.303 upon T log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of AT. Now, we can rearrange this equation as log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0 upon concentration of AT is equal to, if I shift this KT on top, what will I get? KT upon 2.303. Now, let us substitute the values in that formula. Therefore, log to the base of 10. We are going to make use of this formula now. Log to the base of 10 of concentration of A0, which is 0.08. We don't know what is AT, so let us put it as it is equal to KT, that is equal to KT. So, we don't have K also from T half, we can find it KT upon 2.303. So, first let us find out K. So, how will you find out K? K is equal to 0.693 upon T half. You know T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. So, I have rearranged that K is equal to 0.693 upon T half. So, 0.693 upon T half. What is your T half? It is 990 second. Take the log of 0.693 and subtract the log of 990 out of it, take the anti-log, you get the answer as 6.999 into 10 raised to minus 4 per second. K is equal to 6.99. That is approximately it is 7 into 10 raised to minus 4. You can write it has either 6.999 or 7 into 10 raised to minus 4. Per second. Now you got what is K. You can substitute your value of K in this formula. Therefore, log to the base of 10 of 0.08 upon concentration of AT, that is equal to what is K? I am taking 6.99 into 10 raised to minus 4 multiplied by T. T you have to take it as 2100 second. Upon this 2.303. Now again you have to take the log of 6.999 plus the log of 2100 and subtract the log of 2.303 from it. And then take the anti-log of that term obtained, you get your final answer. Okay. So your RHS after calculation will be obtained as 0.6383. Calculate this, you will get your answer as 0.6383. Therefore, now if I shift this, first of all, I'll write it properly here. Log to the base of 10 of 0.08 upon concentration of At, that is equal to 0.6383. Now if I shift the log on that side, this becomes anti-log. Therefore 0.08 upon concentration of At will be equal to anti-log of 0.6383. Find the anti-log of 0.63 in 8 and take the difference of 3. You get that answer as 4.348. So what you get? 0.08 upon concentration of 80 is equal to 4.38. I am writing it here. 0.08 upon concentration of 80 is equal to 4.348. Therefore, concentration of At will be equal to what? Rearrange this. 0.08 upon 4.348. You can find the log of this. Log of 0.08 minus the log of 4.348. So what do you get the log as? Bar 2 point. Log of 0.08 is bar 2.9031. And the log of 4.348. That will be 0.6385. Subtract the 2. You get the answer as bar 2.2646. And then take the anti-log of 0.26 in 4 and add the difference of 6 to it, and this 2 bar I am taking as 10 raised to minus 2. So what do you get as final answer? 0.26 in 4 and the difference of 6, anti-log. What answer do you get? You get it as 1.840 into 10 raised to minus 2. 1.840 into 10 raised to minus 2. So your final answer, that is of concentration of 80, therefore concentration of 80 will be equal to 1.840 into 10 raised to minus 2. Answer will be in mole dm raised to minus 3. As A0 has been given is in mole dm raised to minus 3, At should also be taken in mole per dm cube. Or you can also write it as 0.01840. Concentration of At is also equal to either 1.840 into 10 raised to minus 2 or 0.01840. Or 0.01840. Unit will be same. So we have studied 3 problems based on integrated rate law for first order reaction. Now we will discuss a problem on integrated rate law for gas phase reaction. The problem is, during the first order decomposition of SO2Cl2 at constant volume, the following data was obtained. The decomposition of SO2Cl2 gas gives SO2 gas plus Cl2 gas. The data given to you is time, when time was t is equal to 0, total pressure in bar was 0.5, and when the time was taken as 100, total pressure in bar was given as 0.6. So what has been given to you? P1 has been given to you, that is at time t is equal to 0, 0.5 bar, and when time was taken as 100 second, P is equal to 0.6 bar. P1 at time t is equal to 0 and P at time t is equal to 100. have been given, time has been given, you have to find the rate constant. Calculate the rate constant. So you have to find the rate constant. So what is your formula for integrated rate law for gas phase reaction? It is K is equal to 2.303 upon T log to the base of 10 of P1 upon twice P1 minus P. Now substitute the values. You want K. So K is equal to 2.303 upon T, that is 100 log to the base of 10 of P1 is 0.5 and this is 2 into 0.5 minus P. What is P? It is 0.6. So what you get? 2.303 upon 100 into log to the base of 10 of 0.5 upon. So this will be 1 minus 0.6, that is 0.4. And then you can simplify this 0.5 upon 0.4. So 2.303 upon 100 into log to the base of 10 of 0.5 upon 0.4, that will give you 1.25. And you, again you have to find the log of 1.25, that means 12 in 5, log of 12 in 5. It is 0.0969. 2.303 into, it's a log, log of 1.25, that is 0.0969. Again this 100 as it is. Okay, now 2.303 upon 100, that will give you, I'm shifting this 100 on top, 2.303 into 10 raised to minus 2. I've shifted this 100 on top. So 2.303 into 10 raised to minus 2 into 0.0969. Now you can take the log of 2.303 and log of 0.0969. Add the two logs and then take their anti-log. What I get? 2.303 log is 0.3623. Log of 2.303 is 0.3623 and the log of 0.09, that means log of 96 in 9, 0.0969, that means 96 in 9, that will give you bar 2.96 and 9 madhe log kiti bar 2.9863. Add the 2, you get bar 1.3486, and then again find the anti-log of 0.3486, and this bar 1 I am taking as 10 raised to minus 1. So 0.34 in 8 and the difference of 6 should be added to it. Anti-log of 0.34 in 8 and the difference of 6 should be added to it. What you get? You get that answer as 2.231 and this 10 raised to minus 1, that means 0.2231. I am taking this answer on top here. These are all log calculations. I am taking this answer on top, 0.2231 into this 10 raised to minus 2 again. This 10 raised to minus 2 was left, I have taken it. So your final answer will be either this or you can also write it as 2.231 into 10 raised to minus 3. I have shifted the decimal point ahead, so 0.2231 into 10 raised to minus 2 or 2.231 into 10 raised to minus 3. Final answer will be in per second. So 2.231 into 10 raised to minus 3 per second. That is what is K. K is equal to 2.231 into 10 raised to minus 3 per second. This is your final answer. Friends, today we have studied numericals based on integrated rate law for first order reaction and integrated rate law for gas phase reaction. Such type of numericals may be asked for board exam for almost 3 marks. So, practice all the formulas and numericals as you have seen in today's lecture. Thank you.